Hello children, let me welcome you to the Virtual Training Center of the Brihanmumbai Mahanagar Palika. My name is Shraddha teacher. Children, we are in the middle of the COVID-19 pandemic, isn't it? Because of that, we are not able to go to school. But that doesn't mean that we are going to stop learning. We are going to meet here regularly through the Virtual Training Center to learn many lessons in EVS. So come on, let's go to a lesson in EVS. So, dear students, let us start another lesson, you can say, in third standard EVS. But it will not be a new lesson, children. It will be another video, but not a new lesson. Why? Because we are going to continue what we started last time. Remember, we were doing this lesson on food. We talked about why our body needs food, and we also talked about the food requirements of certain animals. And that time I told you that this is not all for today, children. We are going to continue this lesson next time. Remember? So come on, let us go on and let us do part 2 of the lesson that we started last time. Our need for food. Okay, and in this part of the lesson, we will be talking mainly about the food requirements of animals and that of plants. Now, we all know that animals can move around, animals have their hands and they have their mouths and they eat with their paws, isn't it? They tear the flesh with their teeth. Now, what about plants? Plants cannot move from one place to another, and we cannot see plants also having a mouth or a paws or hands or whatever. Then how do these plants eat? So that also will be very interesting to know. So come on, children, let's start our lesson. But we will start by doing a little bit of revision of what we did last time. So remember, we talked about why we need food. Okay, why as human beings we need to eat food. And if you remember, I showed you many pictures from your textbook also and from outside also, in which we saw how without food all of us would become very weak. We could even fall sick. We also saw that when we eat food well, that time we become healthy. Isn't it? We also saw pictures of a girl falling sick and her mother feeding her, and then the girl becoming healthy. We also saw that food is very, very essential in case we want to grow. So if you want your body to grow well, if you want yourself to have a balanced growth, not only mentally but also physically, it means that we should have good food. We also saw that whenever our bodies are tired, it demands food. How does it demand food? By making us feel hungry, isn't it? Then we went on and we saw some pictures of how animals also eat food. Okay, children? So we discussed about why we human beings need food, and then at the end we also concluded that if you have a good diet, that if you, that is, if you have food in the right quantity, okay, the right kind of food at the right time, then you will always become healthy. So we are what we eat. If you eat healthy, you will be healthy. If you eat unhealthy stuff, then you will also become unhealthy. So all these things we learned and discussed in the first part of this video. Now in that part of the video, we also saw that animals also need to eat, isn't it? So we saw what different animals eat, for example, like what cows eat, what goats eat, horses, and we also talked about different kind of food which is given to the domesticated animals like cows, etc. So we give them oil cakes. Now what are oil cakes? Oil cakes are made by extracting oil. When we extract oil from certain seeds like groundnuts, etc., what we do is whatever is remaining after the oil is extracted, that we make it into a cake. That means we do not bake it in the oven, we just shape it like a cake and we dry it in the sun and feed it to our animals. Okay, we also talked about something called as ambon, which is a mixture of oil cake and jaggery and grain, which is mixed with water and which is dried and used as animal feed.
So all these interesting things we learned last time, children. But you know, the animal kingdom is very vast. Human beings means we talk only about human beings. But when we talk about animals, then you have wild animals, you have domestic animals, you have birds, you have insects. So we are supposed to talk about all of them, isn't it? So come on, let's talk about some animals now in today's lesson. And then towards the end of the lesson, we will also talk about our other friends in nature. That is plants or trees. We will see how they also eat. So we also talked about what birds eat, children. So see, and we discussed that birds can eat all these things. Okay, so birds eat millets, you can say, that ragi, which you can see, it is a kind of a grain. They eat vegetables also, leafy vegetables like coriander, spinach, mint, and they can also eat seeds of different kind of fruits. They can eat maize and fruits, of course. Birds love fruits. So we talked about all this also last time, isn't it? Now let us come to some more animals. So in the beginning, we will talk about some domestic animals, and then we will go to the wild animals. So cats, children, actually they love to eat mice. Okay, you know that there is this very famous cartoon called as Tom and Jerry, where Tom is the cat and Jerry is the mouse, and Tom is forever running in order to kill this Jerry. Okay, so cats, they love to eat mice. That is their natural kind of food. Okay, but they can also eat other things, like they can eat fish, they can eat bread, they can eat eggs, milk, etc. So if you have a cat which you have kept at home, if you have a pet cat, or naturally you will not want it to go and kill mice and eat. So you will feed it all these things. You can feed it fish, you can feed it bread, milk, chapatis also the cats eat. Anything which you give them, they will eat. When they were small, you can say kittens, whatever habit you have given them of feeding them, they will eat that thing only. Okay? And then you know there are special foods which are made for these cats. Like for example, you have whiskers, etc., which are made for these cats. Special cat food that also cats eat. If it is a cat which is your pet, you can feed it this also. Alright? Now what about dogs? Now dogs are actually meat eaters. Okay, they are carnivorous animals, and they are descendants of the fox. That is, they were foxes once upon a time, and wolves, and gradually they changed and they were domesticated, and then they became dogs. So they are actually like these wolves and these foxes. They love to eat meat. Okay, but then if you keep a dog at home, what do? You feed it different things from your kitchen. If you feed the dog whatever you eat, isn't it? So what all things can this dog eat then? The dog can eat chapatis, rotis, bhakris. Look at this one. He's sitting with so many rotis. He doesn't want to share it with anyone. So you must have seen this. People feeding dogs chapatis. They give them bhakris to eat. They give them bread to eat. Isn't it? They're also fed milk and eggs. And you give them dal rice also sometimes. They can eat anything. That is, when they are pets in your home, and when you bring them when they are very small, you can start feeding them anything that you eat, and they will continue with that habit. Though basically they are actually meat eaters, they are carnivorous animals. Okay, so see, even for dogs you have these kind of special food. Okay, now these are for dogs which are pet dogs, because these kind of foods are very expensive. You must have seen the advertisement of Pedigree on your TV sometimes. Okay, so all that is specially made food for the dogs. Okay, so see what or how we have changed these animals. So the cats used to love eating mice, and the dogs used to love eating meat. But then since we made them our pets, since we domesticated them, we have changed their eating habits. Okay, so this is what the pet animals or the domesticated animals, they eat. Now what about animals which live in the wild? That is, animals which are not domestic. Now see, this is a deer. Okay, so you must have never seen a person keeping a deer as a pet. If you do that, the police will come and take you away. Okay, because you're not supposed to keep wild animals at your home as pets. So This is a deer. Can you see what the deer is eating? It is eating grass. So there are certain animals which are not domestic, that is, they are wild animals, but they are herbivorous. Herbivorous means they eat plants. They are vegetarian, you can say, basically. Okay, they like, just like vegetarian people, they eat only fruits, they eat only vegetables, they do not eat meat, fish, etc. In the same way, there are certain wild animals which are vegetarian, that is, they are herbivorous, and the deer is one of them. See what the deer is doing? He's eating grass, isn't it? Now there is one more animal which I want to show you. Now this is a bison. See what the bison is eating? The bison is also eating grass. So there are many animals like this. For example, we have the Nilgai, we have buffaloes, etc., which eat grass, which eat leaves, etc. Sometimes what happens is, when they do not find grass in the jungles, they slowly get into the fields, okay, the farms, and then they start eating away the crops also. That is the time they become a trouble for human beings. But children, at this point, we also have to remember that animals also have a right to live on this earth. Isn't it? What have we done? We human beings have cut down the jungles, and we are keeping on making fields, and we are keeping on making buildings, villages, etc. So these poor animals are left with no choice. Okay, we can think like that also. Alright, so these are some animals which are not domestic. That is, they are wild animals, yet they are vegetarian. What about some wild animals which are not vegetarian? Look at this. It's a lion. Okay, what is it doing? It is chasing a boar. Okay, can you see? And it will catch it and it will eat it. So you see that the lion is not trying to eat grass. Is the lion trying to eat grass? No, it is trying to eat another animal. So that is why we call the lion as carnivorous. Okay, carnivorous means, you can also say, he is a non-vegetarian animal. That is, he eats non-vegetarian khana. He doesn't believe in eating only fruits or only leaves or only vegetables, but he has to eat other animals also. Okay, see this animal. This is another lion lying in wait. You can see so many deer over there. There is a herd of deer, and this lion is waiting. Can you see? And it is waiting for its chance to pounce upon the lone deer. There is one deer which has come away from the group, and the lion goes and attacks it and it eats it. Alright, so that means there are animals which live in the deep jungles. So they hunt other animals and they eat their flesh. Sometimes what happens is, when these lions do not get food in the jungle, that is, they are not able to catch this deer and eat, and it is feeling very hungry, at such times you will see that such animals, they also enter the villages and they kill and eat cattle, hens, that is, fowl, etc. Okay, so this also can happen. Actually, they like to hunt and eat. They like to catch animals in the jungle only and eat. But in case they are not getting food in the jungle, then slowly they might come and they might eat animals from our farms also. In very rare cases, children, once in a while you will also see animals like lions, tigers, leopards, etc., which become man-eaters, because human beings are a very easy target for them. We cannot run as fast as they can, isn't it? And we cannot fight them also, because they are very powerful. So we are easy to catch and eat. So once they get into the habit of eating human beings, they become man-eaters. Alright, you must have seen in movies and serials. But unfortunately then, we kill them to save our own lives. Okay? You will also see certain other animals, like look at this fox. It also tries to enter people's houses to find food. But the fox is a small animal. It cannot eat a cow or it cannot eat a buffalo. For that matter, it cannot even eat a goat. So what do these foxes do? They try and catch hold of hens, ducks, etc., which are smaller in size. So they try and eat those kind of animals. Okay, children. So this was about the food of animals which are not kept at home. That is, they are not pets and they are put in the category of wild animals. So you saw some of these wild animals. They eat grass, they eat plants, they eat fruits. So they are herbivorous. And some others like the tiger, the lion, the fox, etc., they eat other smaller animals and they are carnivorous. Okay, so this was about the need of food for these animals. Now children, let us talk about one simple thing which you will learn when you go to the higher classes, but now we will try to understand it in a very simple way. So here, did you see that in one way or the other, all the animals are connected to each other? Aren't they connected? Let us start by understanding. See, first is there is sunlight. Because of the light of the sun, the plants make their food. You will understand this better when we talk about food of the plants. So because of the sun, the plant makes food. And there are certain animals then which eat these plants. Okay, like for example, the deer. The deer will go and eat the grass or the plant which you can see here. There are certain other animals which eat the deer. For example, the lion. If he is hungry and if he sees a deer in front of him, he will definitely kill the deer and he will eat its flesh. So there are animals which eat other animals. And then there are these really tiny animals or insects which will eat the waste of these other animals. So see, imagine if this insect will not get the waste of this lion or the deer, it will die. Okay, if the lion or the tiger does not get deer to eat, the lion or the tiger will die. And if the deer does not get plants to eat, the deer will die. Okay, and if there is a problem with sunlight, then the plants will not grow. So if you do not allow plants to grow, the herbivorous animals won't be there. If the herbivorous animals won't be there, then the carnivorous animals won't be there. And if the herbivorous and the carnivorous animals both are not there, then all these little insects will also die away one day, isn't it? So what is this entire thing called, children? It is called as the food chain. It is a chain. So just like you have a chain in which you have these different kadis, if you remove one kadi, the chain breaks, isn't it? So that is how nature works. So all these things are important for us. So you should try to see that you do not cut down plants. You should try to see that you save the life of all animals which are living on this earth. Because God has put all of them there for a particular need or for a particular motive. Okay? So one of them is not there, all the other animals will be affected. So this is called as the food chain. Now since we are talking about these little insects, let us see what they eat. Before that, let us talk about the birds. So see, what are these? These are so many birds. They are birds, okay? They are not insects. They are birds. But they are huge in number. And what do? You know, they attack the crops. So you can see the field there, which is ready to be harvested. So that is, I think, jawar or bajra or something like that. And these birds, they come in these huge numbers and they eat away and they destroy the entire crop. They destroy the entire field. Okay, these kind of things also happen, children, sometimes. You can see here. See, they get into the fields and they eat away all the crops. It is not their fault. They are also hungry, isn't it? So what do people do in such cases then? So the farmers have to face huge losses in case something like this happens. So then what do? See what they do. See, here also you can see sometimes these sparrows and other birds who eat away at the grains. So what happens is there is a loss for the farmers. So then the farmers make use of such scarecrows. So can you, have you seen this? In Marathi, you call it, I think, budzgavna. So there is this particular you can say figure of a human being which is made. And see, they have worn a pant, they've put on a pant for that stick, and there is the stick has worn a t-shirt also, there is a cap also, and they've made hands and they've made legs and they've made a head. Okay, and what happens is, when this thing, they make it, they put it in the field, when the scarecrows, they put it in the field, the birds feel that people are standing there. Okay, and the birds do not come forward and attack these kind of fields. So children, isn't it interesting? These are called as scarecrows. You must have seen it when in the fields also sometimes. People also use these kind of bird scarers. They're called as bird scarers. Okay, instead of making a very big, you can say budzgavna, or instead of making a very big scarecrow, you can even make such small things to scare away the bird. So there is this potato, and they have inserted so many feathers, etc., in the potato. So when the bird sees it, it feels this is something different, and they sense some kind of danger, and therefore they do not attack that particular field. All right, see, this is one more example of a bird scarer. So they have cut out a piece of plastic and they've made it look like an owl, and there are two big eyes also, all right, made out of CDs. So this is a bird scarer. Along with this, nowadays there are many electronic devices also which sent out freak vibrations so that the birds do not come near the fields. Okay, so this is something which happens and which is not good for our brothers and sisters who are farmers. So they have to prevent such destruction, and therefore they try to do such things. They try to use slingshots also, and they try to set up a scarecrow. They make use of such bird scarers, okay, to drive away these birds. Now there are certain birds who live near human population. That is, for example, see these sparrows, they live near the place where people live. And what is the reason for that? The reason for that is they get ready-made food to eat. You must have seen sparrows if you are living in a village. Now if you are living in cities, unfortunately, it is difficult to sight such sparrows, etc. But if you are living in a village, you must have seen lots of sparrows. They are called as house sparrows. Okay, see, they're eating away at cooked food. So someone has put cooked food outside on the road and these sparrows are feeding on them. They might also eat raw grains. Okay, and you must have seen people feeding them also. There are many people who feed these sparrows, they feed these pigeons. So if you ever come to Mumbai, then you will see there are places which are officially called as kabutar khanas, where people feed these pigeons, where there are big feeders kept, and these pigeons go there and they feed in huge numbers. Okay, so this is one interesting thing. So there are many animals like the pigeons, the crows, the sparrows, which live close to human beings. Why? Because they do not want to go and attack the fields. They know that they will get ready-made food when they stay near to the human population. All right, children, let's move on and let's talk about these friends of ours who are also in one way or the other useful for us. Okay, but at the same time, some of them can be a nuisance also for us. But anyways, let us see what these tiny creatures eat. So what all animals can you see here? Which all creatures can you see here? There is a beetle in the middle. Then there is a housefly, which is very, very harmful for us. Okay, houseflies spread different kind of diseases. Then you can see the image of a butterfly, and of course, ants. Alright, let us see one more image of some more animals who actually we consider as pests in our house. So you have the cockroaches, you have lizards, okay, then bed bugs and mice and spiders. Now these are all tiny creatures, but children, they also need food. Isn't it? They cannot survive if they do not eat. So what do they eat? What do these tiny creations of God, what do they eat? So they also have their own, you can say, menu when it comes to eating. So bed bugs, they suck human blood. Okay, remember, these animals cause a lot of diseases also. Okay, so it is not good if you have pests at home. What should you do? You should try to drive them away from your homes. So bed bugs, they will settle in your bed. Why are they called bed bugs? Because they are found usually in the mattresses in your home. They will suck on your blood. Okay, they will suck your blood, then they will suck someone else's blood, and this is how they transmit diseases. So these are one kind of tiny creatures that you find in your house. See, they also suck blood of animals. If you have had dogs at home, you must have seen these kind of animals on the skin of your dog. They are very tiny in the beginning, and then finally they start growing, and they become like a small balloon. Okay, because of sucking the blood of this dog. These children, these small things, even though they suck the blood of animals, they can sometimes bite human beings also and cause different kind of diseases like tick fever, not only in animals but also in human beings. Look at this lizard. See, he's nicely caught hold of that spider and he's eating the spider. The spider in turn will eat a fly or a mosquito, isn't it? See, this is one more, you can say, type of lizard. See how nicely it caught the ant and it ate the ant up. So every animal, children, eats. Whether it is a human being, whether it is a big animal, whether it is a small animal, whether it is a domestic animal, a wild animal, an animal which you take as pet in your house, whether it is cattle, all kinds of animals need to eat. That is what we came to know from this part of the lesson, isn't it? See here, this is a worm. You must have seen these kind of worms in cauliflowers and a fulgobi. When you buy these fulgobi or flower, as we call it, and if you're not very careful, then you might end up chopping a few of these worms also along with the vegetable. So see what it is doing? It is eating some kind of leaf. Okay, so these worms also, they need to eat. So we just discussed that all types of animals eat. Look at this beautiful butterfly. Can you see that the proboscis, or what you call it, it is a feeder of the butterfly. Okay, it is inserting that into a plant and it is sucking the nectar from that particular flower. So there is not a single animal on this earth that does not need to eat. Now let us go to our other friends in nature, that is plants. So what kind of plants are these? These are potted plants. That means these are plants that we have in our house. So for these plants, we give them water and we give them different kind of fertilizers. Even the plants which are there in our fields, our crops, we give them water, we give them fertilizers, etc. But wild plants also, they also need to make food. Now remember, children, plants are the only things that do not consume other living things. They make their own food. Now how do plants make their own food? Do they have a kitchen? Do they need knives and pots and pans? Let us see. So see, this is how plants eat food. So plants need food. Just like us human beings, plants also need food. So can you see the root of the plant, which is inside the ground, in the soil? The root pulls up certain nutrients from the soil and through the stem it gives to the leaves. Okay, all right. So can you see, this is one way in which the plants live, or they gather food for themselves. Then there is one more thing. You can see this is a leaf. Okay, on the surface of this leaf, if you look at it under a microscope, you will see there are tiny pores on them. There are tiny holes on this leaf. Now it is through these holes that air enters the leaves. So just like human beings need air, we need water, we need food, in the same way these plants also need air, water and food. So the plants absorb water from the soil, isn't it? And also along with the water, the plants also absorb some other nutrients which are there in the soil. So you can see the blue dots are all water and the other yellow dots are certain other things which the plant gets from the soil. And the plant gets air from these pores on the leaf. So if you try looking at a leaf, you might not see these pores. But if you look at a leaf under the microscope, then you will see that you will see these pores. Okay, so whatever air and whatever water is absorbed, it comes together in this leaf. So the leaf will absorb the air and the root will also pull out the water and send it to the leaf through the stem. So the leaf becomes like a kitchen for the plant. Can you see? So the leaf, along with the sunlight and along with the water and the air that it got, what it will do? It will make food for the plant. So plants make their own food using the water and the air in the leaf. And also the most important thing for plants to make food is the sunlight. Now when you grow up a little bit more and when you go to a higher class, you will learn what this process is called and how it happens, etc. in detail. Now for third standard level, since it is an EVS lesson, it is important for you to just remember that plants make their own food using water, which is pulled up by the roots, and using air, which is absorbed by the leaves, and the most important thing is sunlight. Okay, so see here how the water, H2O means water, water is pulled up by the leaf and the air is also pulled in by the leaf. Okay, CO2 is carbon dioxide, pulled in by the leaf and the sunlight. And you can see how the plant makes food for itself in the leaves. Okay, so what is the most important thing for plants to make their own food? It is the leaves, or you can say it is sunlight. Without sunlight, the leaves will not be able to make any kind of food for the plant. So children, like I told you now, it is the plants on which everything else is dependent. It is only plants which can make their own food. Now you will say, teacher, we also make our own food. We also get sabji from the market and we cut it and we cook it. But remember, you're getting the sabji from the market. You are not capable of pulling out your own sabji from your hands or your legs, isn't it? So let us see this particular image, you will come to know. See, these are the plants which are eaten by the deer, and the deer is eaten by the tiger, isn't it? So if there are no plants, there will be no deer and no tiger. Look at the other example here. See, these plants are eaten by these insects. These insects are eaten by the frog. The frog is eaten by the snake. And the snake is eaten by the eagle. So if there are no plants, there will be no insect, no frog, no snake, no eagle. Similarly here, see the scorpion, then the fish, and then the fish-eating bird. So all these things, in one way or the other, they are all dependent on plants. Okay? So even though the tiger does not directly eat plants, the tiger indirectly eats plants, because the tiger eats the deer which eats the plant. So indirectly, the tiger is also, you can say, dependent on plants. So now you know what is the most important thing for all of us in nature. It is plants. That is why we always encourage you, isn't it? Your teacher always tells you, plant more trees, do not cut trees, etc. And then we have human beings who will eat all these things. We human beings, we are capable of eating all of these things. We eat plants also, we eat animals also, we eat insects also, isn't it? So this was about our need for food. When we say our, we do not mean only human beings, but we also mean the plants, the animals, the insects, etc. So children, this was this particular lesson which we did in two parts. So you can watch part one of this lesson in the video which I have put up earlier. And this was part two of the lesson. So hope you have understood in great detail about food or our need for food.
So children, now you have watched the video. So after you watch the video now, you will have to complete a few simple tasks. Now you might have watched the video on your computers or your laptops or your mobile phones. Now after you watch the video, what will you do? You will please go to the description box which is given below the video. So what is the description box? See, the description box looks like this. Alright, and after you go to the description box, you will see that there are a few questions there. Now, what are these questions about? These questions are about the lesson that we just learned or the video that you just watched. So, what will you do? You will think back properly about the lesson and you will try and answer these questions and note down the answers in your notebook if you want. Okay, after that we have another task waiting. You will also click on the link which you will find in the description box to fill up the Google form. So now what is the Google form, children? It is nothing but a simple form. There are a few simple questions there about the video which you just saw and also about yourself. So these are the tasks now that you will have to complete after you watch each video. So children, wasn't that a very interesting lesson? I'm sure you learned a lot of new things in this lesson. If you have liked this video, please hit the like button and also subscribe to my video so that you will get to see all the videos which I keep posting regularly.